Damn!
Yo, what is up, guys? This is our second vlog. Thank you for joining me again. As you can see, we got the Evo back. It's been about a month that I was in the shop getting some electrical issues all figured out, but you know, we got it back. We're gonna be installing some parts that I got, so let's get to that. But before we get to that, let's get a cold start for the boys. Can probably read from the title, we are going to be installing airlift suspension on my Evo 10. I got these from my boy Hector down in Texas. Shout out to Hector, and yeah, let's get to it.
Low car problem.
Before we jack it up, make sure to check off the lug nuts while they're still on the ground. Otherwise, you're gonna be having a hard time doing it. All right, so we just took off all the wheels on both sides. Now we are gonna remove the coilovers from the vehicle and put them to the side. Before we remove all the coilovers off the car, I'm gonna be taking all the interior pieces out so we can route the lines without having any issues. All right, so I got majority of the panels taken off. Just gonna be sliding it through here, same as the back, but I'm going to be taking these seats off so I can route it all the way to the trunk right there. So you guys will be needing all these to complete your air suspension setup. You know, the front two struts, two rears, all your hardware, you know, two compressors, the manifold that controls everything, the tank, and also all your wiring harness. So you might be wondering to yourself, oh, that guy knows how to do air suspension, but we about to learn together, boys. Let's get it. We need to remove this bolt right here, and also the brake line, and we'll be able to take out the coilover and swap it out with the new one. Before you remove them, these nuts on these side are gonna be 19 millimeter, and there's also a 12 mil right here that you have to push off and then get the top, and then you should be all good. There's also a trick to do. Grab one of these extensions. When you do hit those out, because this rotor will drop, I believe, so you want to get a jack and jack up the top so there's not a lot of tension restricting everything. And you should be able to take both of them, so there you go. All right, since we got this part free, we're going to be going up top using a 14 mil and getting these three nuts off. You're gonna wanna make sure that you're holding the coilover underneath, otherwise it's just gonna fall right through and you don't want that. The coilover is out. Okay, well, I'm gonna be doing the same on the passenger side. the rears, and I'll get back to you guys. All right, I lied, guys. I'm going to be installing the front before I do that, because I do have that jack underneath and I'm gonna need it for the other side. So everything is gonna be the same, you know, process, but you know, vice versa, everything. It doesn't really matter which side you guys decide to do first, but I'm gonna be doing the driver's one first. So everything is just gonna be the same as earlier. Someone helping you, but I'm doing it by myself. So look, make sure when you do this, try to line it up perfectly so you don't have to have all the trouble. Also, I believe this bolt right here, you have to put it a certain way compared to this one, you know, it's a little different. So I believe that red dot is, you have to point it inwards of the car. So let's get to that. And just like that, everything is bolted in. We just got to do the top and make sure these are all torqued down to spec. I'll list it right here. Like that, we got both the driver and fronts on. Now that we are getting to the rears, you're gonna have to take most of this out, take all these little pins off the cover, and then we shall be able to access the two rear struts. Okay, so when you do the rears, there's gonna be another 14 millimeter bolt holding this strut, and then there's two 14 millimeter bolts, one right here and then one on the other side. Same thing for this side, so let's get to it. Check this up and then have this part hold the rotor up as well while you're pulling the long bolt out. Easier. Okay, if you're doing this single-handedly like I am today, it's easier to leave a bolt here loose. Since we got both of the bolts on top out, now all we need to do is release this jack and this should pop right out. That's the rears off the car. Got the last strut in. All four corners are now in. Now we gotta run the lines. just unpackaged all the lines. I'm gonna run them through that hole over there. Same thing over there. I'm gonna route them through the side of the car and to the front for that strut, and the same thing on that side. Okay, well, it's been a few hours later. What I ended up doing was I drilled two holes underneath the car. So, I don't know if you can see it, but it's right there. And one goes to that strut, while the other one goes to that strut. Well, I ran most of the lines to the front already. As you guys can see, I got an airline, and then we have the fuse relay line, and also we have the line that hooks up to the controller right there. Yo, what's up guys? Well, what happened yesterday was it got a little too dark out, so we're just gonna continue where we left off, but ended up putting a cover over the car. What happened was we ran into some issues where we ran out of quarter inch line, and we actually don't have a fitting that we needed, and this is a fitting. We got to go to the hardware store and go pick up a different one, so catch you guys in a second. We just got back from Home Depot, picked up a couple things for the car, and let's get to work. Okay, so what I ended up doing was I cut out the paper that was in this pamphlet. If you cut out the compressor, it shows the template. So now what we're gonna do is bring this paper to the back of the trunk. And what we're gonna do is place it where we wanna be drilling the compressors. And then I'm gonna find the holes and drill them out for the tank. So I'll get back to that. Okay, so I drilled the holes right here. There's 8 of them. Then I'm going to drill them out, and then we're going to put the compressors in these 8 holes on each side. So we're just going to test fit these to see if they all line up correctly. If I did it correct, they should all pretty much line up. Looks pretty good, but we're going to put a screw through them and see if it all fits properly. Now we got both the compressors mounted to the floorboard. We're gonna try to figure out the holes for the tank now. Probably gonna mount the manifold somewhere like this, so it's pretty clean, so those lines match up. But now we ran into another issue where this fitting is stuck. You know, there's a line in there, and you know, gonna try to have to figure out somehow to get that out, or you know, see if we can get this fitting replaced, because I'm not really trying to pay for a new manifold right now, because this thing alone is a grand. So wish me luck. Okay, from the last part that you guys saw, I was, you know, having trouble with this specific fitting that was for the tank, and you know, I got it fixed. You know, there was this broken line that was stuck in there, but I did end up ordering a new part from Bag Riders. It came in here 2 days later. But yeah, as you can see, I got it a little scuffed, but you know, that's what's gonna happen in order to get it out. I did have to use a knife that I did end up breaking. But yeah, you're gonna really need like you know, a flathead screwdriver and like a little mallet, but watching this video definitely helped me a lot. So if you guys are having the same kind of problem I did, I definitely recommend doing this. I'll have this video linked in the bottom. Yeah, so now we are going to get the new fitting right here, and we're going to be using a 14 millimeter socket. We're going to use this socket, put this right here, put this on top, and then we're going to be hitting the brass part and not the plastic. See how it goes right over? You won't break that, and push it down and you should be all set. Make sure that you clean the outside and also the inside with some kind of alcohol or something, so you don't have any debris or any leaks in the future. Okay guys, as you guys saw, I did have to hammer it pretty hard, so I did leave a little scuff mark around it, but the only important thing is that it lays flat, just like the rest of them, you know, so there's no leak in the future. But, you know, it might look a little crummy, but if it really bothers me that bad, I will replace it. But as long as it works, you know, knock on wood, everything is fine. But, you know, there you go. That's how you fix a manifold. Guys, if you guys can see, I kind of jerry-rigged everything right now, just for now. Make sure everything works, but the compressor is working. The tank is filling up, as you guys can hear. And also, the controller is finally turned on. You know, I hooked up everything, so just kind of testing everything for now, see if everything works fine, and then I'll put everything properly, you know? Okay, so it was leaking from this one earlier, but after I installed the second compressor, and then I thought I fixed it, and then the water tank was leaking from the bottom, but as you can see, can't really hear it leaking anymore. But make sure that this is vertical, and you know, everything seems to be okay right now. It's just still loading the PSI because only one compressor is on right now, so we're gonna wait and see what happens next. Okay, so we kind of ghetto rigged this for now just to test if it works. Both compressors aren't working now. Everything sounds good. I'm gonna mock everything up and put it on the hardwood, and we'll go from there. All right, so I bolted the hardwood floor in, and then I'm gonna fix it this weekend, but I'm gonna add the carpet and stuff. This is how it looks like right now, mounted with everything. Have the water tap right there, all the lines, and all the air hoses connected. Gonna get that all fixed. All right guys, we just finished putting on the bags. This is gonna be our first reaction to how low it sits, all right?
Let's go. Are y'all ready? Let's get it. That look good.
Ooh, let's go.
So I'll wait till them go. Is it pretty high though?
Yeah.
Are you recording yourself right now?
Yeah.
Okay, you ready? You ready?
Yeah. Damn!
Dude, here's Larry! Holy shit! Well, that concludes that video of me installing my bags. I just want to say I appreciate everyone for sticking around and, you know, seeing my car slam for the first time. You know, pretty happy for how far we've come. But I just want to say thank you again. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll catch you in the next video. Bye-bye.